Comedy genre. Woo, so tonight we'll get to see what we've been working on since September.
Yeah, that's right. So we are going to play for you a two-act show, completely improvised, about how to fall in love.
Aww.
And that's really great.
Yes.
Yeah. So we're wondering, is there anybody in the house who has seen improv before? Please clap your hands. Clap your hands too. Great. So, we have a few questions about romantic comedies, right?
I think we need to explain what improv is.
Yes.
Improv is theater but without a script. So everything you will see here on stage tonight is completely made up on the spot. We have absolutely no clue what's going to happen. And it's all inspired by your suggestions. So you don't need to come on stage, don't worry, you're safe and sound there, no problem. But we need your energy, we need your suggestions, we need your support, because the more of that we get, the better we're going to be. So to get that, we're going to get you a bit warmed up.
Yeah, that's right. So we want to know, like, when you think about romantic comedies, which films have you seen? Which movies? Yell it out.
Titanic.
Love Actually.
Love Actually.
Forgetting Sarah Marshall.
Forgetting Sarah Marshall.
How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days.
Couple more.
The Notebook.
Sleepless in Seattle.
Casablanca.
Oh.
Notting Hill.
Yeah. Yeah.
Bridget Jones.
Nice.
Yeah. Great.
Okay, so now we want to know what is typical for a romantic comedy. What kind of situations are typical to see in a movie like that?
Goofy guys.
Goofy women.
Goofy women, yes.
Yeah.
Hot dogs.
Wedding cakes.
High school drama.
Hilarious mistake.
Weird neighbors.
We're neighbors.
Guarantee.
Clumsy first date.
What else did we have?
Unexpected meeting in the street.
In the rain.
In the rain.
We all can feel that.
I think they're warmed up.
Yeah, I think definitely so. Mm-hmm. So we only have one more thing to ask for before we start this show, and that is the most important thing. And we need help with a title for this romantic comedy. So we want you to yell out suggestions for us, and then you get to name the show tonight. So do you have any suggestions for a romantic comedy that hasn't been played yet?
And will never be played again.
Kiss Me Tomorrow.
In Love Again.
More?
Snowstorm.
What's your name?
Snowstorm. What's her name?
Lost in Snowman's Land.
Kiss Me Tomorrow.
Kiss Me Tomorrow.
The cancelled friend request.
Kiss Me Tomorrow.
Kiss Me Tomorrow.
Ha ha ha!
there.
No.
It was London 1994. And apparently no one was single in London. It was everyone was in a couple and happy, except for a very few number of people. It was really hard for them. It was the beginning of fall. It was very windy and rainy and all that stuff you get in the fall.
We know how it feels.
We do. I'm trying to find my way. I'm gonna do an interview. It's as a secretary.
Sorry.
He was alone. Do you know where find me now is? It's supposed to be on the street.
Find me now.
Oh yes, it's just a few blocks down. Kiel.
Good luck with
the
interview.
Yes.
The interviewee should be here in a few minutes.
Yes, I have prepared all of the paperwork.
All good. So you have a good feeling about this one then?
Yes, I'm really excited about this one.
Sorry, mate. Is this the dating support thing?
Yes. Take
down.
A seat. How many dates have you been on this week?
None.
Mm-hmm. How many dates have you been on this month?
None.
Mm-hmm. How many dates have you been on this year?
It was November, so just one date that whole year.
It's been a long time.
Do you use our service?
Yeah, but it hasn't worked out for me. It's broke up with my girlfriend, it was 2 years ago, and it's tough. I've even considered moving out of London. And then I'm thinking, Brian, don't move out. Stay here. But I'm losing hope.
The fact was that Brian, he liked to do all the other things than dating. He knew that he needed to find someone to find happiness, but he just found things that he would do instead.
Great serve, Brian! Woo!
This is tough. This is... Oh!
For real life. I don't do any apps.
That's the best way.
Yeah. So, this show.
I got good reviews. Oh, they're starting.
Oh, please, take my apples with you.
I would never take your apples with me.
No, how am I supposed to survive? I'm such a poor young lady. I'm also a poor young lady. And you're taking my apples and the peels of my apples.
These are our apples.
You're so much like bullies.
To have or not to have an apple? That is the question.
The question.
I don't know what to do. I thought, what can I do, Brian? I'll talk to Big Sister, and hopefully she... I don't know what to do, Suzanne.
All I can understand, I've been married for 5 years, so...
Yeah, you don't have to rub it in my face every time. Sorry, yes.
No, I don't know what to tell you. I mean, you should be able to meet people at all these events you go to. The fencing and horseback riding.
That wasn't my favorite. But the fence, the Greek fencing was really cool.
Yeah. I mean, ring. There are people at those events, right? Single people?
Hello! I just got this mobile phone, it's really good.
Hello, this is Brian.
Yes, it's, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. You must be on one of those new devices.
Yeah, it's a Nokia 1010.
Yes. So, I am from the dating agency and we'd like to offer you the job.
They gave me the job.
Would you accept it?
This was his call in life. Of course he accepted
it. Yes, I'm accepting it. You'll need to brief me on what the job is.
Suddenly there were purpose in his life. If he couldn't get love, then maybe he could make other people find love.
Okay, I'm supposed to drink it like this.
Christina, that you never went in.
But you know, if I did enter the room, I'm sure I would have gotten the job. I mean, who would have wanted that job anyway? It was like, to get hired by a dating service. Are you supposed to date people for money or what? What is that? I didn't even get the... I thought it was, or I said it was secretary to some people on the street, but I think, I'm not sure what kind of job it was.
I found the applicant service, and you know, I get very curious about this stuff because I care about you, so I actually kept it. Do you want me to read it for you? So maybe you'll be better prepared next time.
Well, now you went through my stuff, so go ahead.
We're roommates. We need to... You live in the living room. It's my area, too. You're not paying rent, so you need to live in the living room, okay?
Okay, Sophia, and read the application, whatever thing.
Okay, Christina, don't get an attitude now. We're supposed to agree on stuff. Okay, so the job that I thought that you could apply for is that you were supposed to be a researcher, so you're supposed to go undercover and go on dates and then report back on how the app is doing. That was the whole idea. So for me, I thought it would be a great like way for you to get a job, get some money so you can pay rent.
What if I like the first person I go on a date with? Should I continue dating?
No, it's specifically said that you can never go on a second date, Christina.
So I'm like this invisible person that will stay invisible forever?
Oh. Come back to the dating service.
It's been a week. I hope you guys are satisfied with what I've been doing, so...
Have you been able to download our app to your Pentium computer?
Yeah. And I actually had to buy Windows 95 because it wasn't working.
You can expense that.
Yes.
Okay,
that's a work expense.
That's good. Can I have a mouse? I could use it.
Yes.
Also, yeah. And I don't have a lot of space because it's really big in my, and I don't have a lot of space in my apartment. You know, with, like, the screen is too deep as well.
You can have a desk here.
Yeah, that, yeah. That's a really big one.
Christina, come! Be brave!
Come in, please.
Hi.
Sorry we bothered you. We're not, we walked in the wrong direction. Sorry.
No, Christina, no. Christina is here for her first interview. She was supposed to come yesterday, but she's here now. And I'm here for moral support.
Come in, Christina.
You can do this, honey. I'm her best friend, so.
I'm Brian.
I'm Christina.
Okay, Christina, it was disappointing that you weren't here yesterday morning, but if you would please pull up a seat, you can have your interview now.
Christina was lucky, because in this firm, they always hired two people and they worked in pair, like partners.
How many days have you been on this week?
None.
Mm-hmm. How many days have you been on this month?
None.
Mm-hmm. How are these relevant questions for a job?
We are a dating agency, yeah.
We need to ascertain your dating ability.
How many days have you been on this year?
None.
Can you lighten up the attitude? She's very sensitive.
Mr. Anderson and Mrs. Anderson, this is not easy for single people. For you, it's easy. I shouldn't be saying I'm with a trial period and everything. People come in here and need help. So.
Thank you for your opinion, Brian. What is your opinion?
You have an opinion.
No. I just don't want to be lonely anymore. And I'm one of those people who, like, read the back of the milk cartons and think that perhaps someone will put their face on there one day. That would be, like, the person for me.
Or that
I would stumble into someone on the street and that would be the person for me. Or
I tend to read on, like, packaging and stuff and notice, like, the grammar and misspellings and everything. It's just something I found.
You do?
Yeah.
He's funny, Christina.
So, you're hired. You two will be partners.
Yay!
Sophie.
Yes?
I'm worried about my brother, Brian. I mean, he's been single for years and years and years. And I'm so happy. I just want him to have what we have.
Yeah, but he's...
We have to find him someone. He's hopeless.
Yeah, and so special.
He's very special.
He's very special.
Does his fencing.
Yeah.
Always come here in bad situations.
We need to find him someone. Yes. So I was thinking maybe your cousin, Vicky.
Yeah,
she's single, right? She's not on and off.
Right.
Yeah. We could try with her.
Okay.
Cool. So, Vicky.
Yeah.
So I got laid last night.
So will you? Are you seeing?
I'm seeing everybody. So I have a date for you.
Really?
Like a serious date?
Aww.
But you...
Vicky.
Yeah, I mean... You You aren't getting any younger, right?
I'm 27. I always have been. Okay, great. I'll call him.
Yeah, she said yes.
I have this new Nokia 1010.
Cool. Yes.
Hello. Hey.
Brian. Hi, it's your sister.
Oh yeah, I saw your name on the caller ID thing. Amazing.
I have a date for you.
A date?
Yeah, it's Sophie.
Super nice.
What's her name?
Vicky.
Vicky. Yeah.
Victoria. Vicky.
Vicky. Victoria.
Yeah, but, she's nice.
Okay, what does she? She's single, right?
She's very pretty and funny and really like down to earth. So relaxed with life and knows what she wants.
Oh, that's good. Yeah.
She's 27.
We told her that you were like really, really handsome and that you like are so super charming.
Like, don't oversell me. Come on. You know how it turns out. Then I get all nervous and blubbery and blah blah blah. And you know I stop.
Don't worry. Look, we booked a restaurant for you Saturday night at 7.
What kind of restaurant?
Italian.
Spanish.
Give me that wine, waiter. I'm supposed to see a person here.
Brian.
Oh.
I'm Brian, nice to meet you.
Hi.
Fair handshake. I'm
Vicky, yeah.
Vicky, so short for Victoria, right?
Yeah, I don't like Victoria, and okay. I always say Vicky when doing like this.
Okay, yeah. So you're Vicky.
I'm Vicky.
It looks like they're doing fine over there.
I'm Brian, and I tend to go like this one. I'm Brian. So yeah, I heard you're 27.
This was such a good idea.
Yes,
to book a table at the same restaurant so we could watch them.
And also get a date night.
So tell me, Brian, do you like the wine?
Well, yeah, the wine's good. I'm seeing that actually they misspelled the word for castle and...
Well, I thought this would be an appropriate restaurant. It's the first day. We shouldn't like pay that much money if this doesn't go so well. So I took this one in the corner, the Spanish Italian restaurant.
It's nice, and I like that they have some dancing music at the same time. And there's supposed to be a show tonight, right?
There's supposed to be an Italian salsa fencing dance.
I was supposed to go on dates, right?
Yes, how did they go?
I haven't been on any dates yet. I've been sitting behind my screen. It's nice, it's color and all, but...
Brian was on a date. Weren't you on a date, Brian?
I was on a date, but it wasn't organized by this company, I'm sorry.
We don't approve of such things.
I know. But it didn't go so well. We were supposed to be partners, you were saying? So, huh?
Yes. So each of you need to date at least 3 people per week. And you should also go out together to restaurants and have a lot of fun and draw a lot of attention to yourselves and talk loudly about how you met through our service.
There was a strict policy in this dating service app company, which I now will name Dating Incorporated. There was a strict policy that people that are have this profession called secret daters. That's what they do. They can never ever date each other.
So as you know, you can never ever date each other except on the fake dates where you are discussing loudly how great our service is, but if it goes any further than that, you're both fired.
That's okay.
We lose too many people. We need to have a very strict policy. Our staff turnover has been terrible. We had to come to this conclusion.
So that explains how I got the job.
Brian, it's really nice that you would come out to lunch with me.
Yes.
I felt I needed to talk to you man to man.
I'm here for you. Yeah. Alexander, I think we all go through tough phases at times, and I understand that, and I can see you're not doing well.
No. I see you being on dates. How is it to be on a date?
It was a date, singular, first. And it was a disaster. It was a disaster. She introduced herself like 10 times, and we're like, Vicky, every time. She was nice, but it wasn't meant to be.
Okay, so you're ready for your first date?
Yes.
Yeah, you look amazing, Christina. Twirl, twirl. Okay, cool. Okay, so it's only you and Brian going out?
Yes.
How does it work? Like, you go out and you pretend to date each other?
Yes, and then we're supposed to say the name out loud of the company.
Dating Incorporated?
Yes, exactly. So, I'm meeting him now, so...
Oh, then you're gonna be late, no, Christina. Have luck. Have luck, that's my new thing to say.
Have luck.
Have luck.
Have luck. Have luck. Hi, I'm Brian.
How handsome you look, Brian, that I found on Dating Incorporated. What is that?
So it's really nice. It's a really nice restaurant that that we get to book on Dating Incorporated.
They get the meal for free? My God!
I really like your dress.
Thank you, stranger. I like your tie.
Oh, this Dating Incorporated thing sounds amazing.
Yes.
They're so nice to each other.
Yes!
I wonder how you contact them. They must have an office somewhere.
Yes.
And I'm glad I actually took that landline phone number to call you, because otherwise, I don't know how I would have ever heard about this office.
Yes, 10555.
I think you can also fax them.
Yes, 10444444.
So, what do you do for a living?
I don't work for Dating in
That would be stupid.
Oh, you work for it, and then it's not fake.
No, I probably have a very interesting job, like a hairdresser or vice president.
And I am not a vice president, but I would like to be one.
And I'd like to change vice president.
Oh. I changed careers as well. I used to be a professor of Greek fencing. And I changed to to accountant.
Why do you meet such interesting people?
I was first in line before you got ahead.
I'll take second in line. That's
fine. I'm sleeping here.
We all want to get in.
I want to get in.
I'm getting the warning.
I want to get in too.
It's 45 minutes left to be open. 45
I heard they have knights in charming in riding armor. I don't know how to say it. Knights riding on white horses.
That sounds so sexual.
Yes, it sounds really sexual. Let me in!
Oh, I'm going in to datingincorporated.com. Oh, such nice ladies. It's the future, going online to find dates, not having to go to an office. So great.
I've been waiting for a date for... I mean, it's been 11 weeks now.
Oh my God!
Oh my God.
I haven't dated since Tuesday.
I haven't dated since
1992. I have two kids, so I never date.
Mr. Anderson,
free food.
Mr. Anderson, it seems like we have a problem.
Yes, Mrs. Anderson. I know we have the same last name.
Yes. That's why I call you Mr. Anderson. So, there are people waiting outside our offices. They apparently don't understand the concept of what we're trying to provide for the people. It is ahead of its time.
Haven't they heard of the World Wide Web?
I don't know that they have.
Open the door!
Open the door!
We want a date!
This is Brian and Christina's fault. They must have been giving out our address and phone numbers instead of the website.
More dates for the single people!
Give us dates!
Give us dates!
This is useless. I'm leaving.
So, how did it go yesterday?
Good, but I think... I actually really liked it. I think this job might be the one for me. Yes.
How much does it pay?
£10 per night.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's good. Then maybe you can help out with the food and I'll also pay the rent.
But I want to say thank you for, like, I know I didn't want to get the job, but how I think it might be for me.
Suzanne, I had the most amazing date yesterday.
With Vicky?
No, not with Vicky. No, we didn't have it. No.
You found someone else?
Yeah.
On your own?
Yeah, I know. I'm surprised myself.
We found someone else? Oh!
Wait. Don't jump.
We're slow.
Nothing happened.
For you. Of course it happened.
Nothing. We're not allowed to date.
Hi, Vicky. I just wanted to check if you want to go on a second date.
Well,
I can do this.
Well, technically, I was supposed to go on 3 dates a week. So yes, yeah, I would love that. That way, I can actually do my job.
I mean, look what we have done.
My brother, the womanizer.
Who would have thought?
Who would have thought?
I mean, I know you were the womanizer, but him.
I'll see you tonight, then.
Ryan. Oh. it's you again.
Hi. This is the second time I've seen this one.
Yeah, kiss me tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. It's my favorite.
It's my favorite one.
Sorry,
that's my seat over there. So,
I looked for you after the last play.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I thought that in the second act, when, you know, when the main protagonist started to cry, it really moved me, and I wanted... Yeah. It seemed like you would get that.
Yeah. Yeah, I like to cry a lot. Like, I cry, I go home. I like to laugh sometimes.
Oh, this part is so sad. He's gonna break up with her. But she doesn't know yet.
But we all know.
To ask her out. Everyone thinks we're married because we have the same last
name. Okay.
But I would really like that to happen.
So I guess then you won't split the bill then.
No.
I was hoping Mr. Anderson would come. I told him to meet at this restaurant, but I realized that there are two locations and I wasn't specific about which of the locations we were supposed to meet at.
Yeah, I wish there was a way to actually find out this kind of information. Like the Blue Rabbit, how specific can it be so that there are two restaurants named that way?
Exactly.
So annoying.
Very frustrating. Did you know that Mr. Anderson and I are not married?
You are not married? So you guys are, and you're not married to other people either?
No. My husband died 14 years ago. His name was also Mr. Anderson. Yes, please.
Yes, right for me.
Well, Brian, since Mr. Anderson doesn't seem to be coming to this dinner meeting, I guess we should discuss your performance at work.
Okay.
How are the dates going?
The dates are going okay. I had in total 3 dates. Three dates, including one with Christina, and where we did all the publicity we were supposed to do, and I think it worked out really well. As you've seen, like, we've had more business coming in, so I think I'm doing really good, and I'm starting to enjoy this job, I have to say. It's important to me.
Good, thank you, Brian. We did have a lot of business after we cleared up that whole misunderstanding about actually coming into the office rather than visiting the website on the World Wide Web. But I think, and Mr. Anderson thinks too, he told me before, that you and Christina should continue doing what you're doing and step it up to a couple times a week. But you still have to go on your other 3 dates.
Would make me a very busy man, but I'm okay. I don't have a lot to do at home.
That's why we hired you.
I know.
And Brian started to go on all these dates. There are so many of them.
I think you're saying really funny things.
Do you think I say funny things?
Yeah. I love the way you say your name.
So
So these are all the pictures of my cats.
Okay, so what are their names?
Susan?
I can burp on command.
So you're paying for dinner, right?
Well, no, this is a date we're supposed to both pay after.
Oh, really? How modern are you?
Well, yeah, you know, you want to be open for anything and then.
My boyfriend broke up with me yesterday.
And you're already on a date?
Christina, I know you went to the show yesterday, the Kiss Me Tomorrow show.
Yes.
Yeah, and
so sad.
Oh, well, that's too sad.
You know, she thinks they're gonna get back together, and then he breaks up with her,
yeah.
And she doesn't know anything. It's the best.
Do you know what? Since I can sense how you're feeling.
Mm-hmm.
Something feels different
today.
You've been so upbeat, even though you're crying for the show. It's just like,
you're right.
Did something happen or what?
You know what?
I feel different.
You look different.
Yeah, I know.
The glow.
What's
going on?
But she's my colleague, and if we date, we're gonna both get fired and banned from the dating app forever.
What kind of a contract is that?
I know. When you're desperate for a job, you sign anything.
I know, yeah, I know, right.
But I think I love her.
I feel I have purpose now. Like, I have a job that I'm actually good at. That I go to every day, and it's fun.
Screw the job! Go for her!
You can be as happy as I am with Sophie. So happy.
But you don't work at the same company, you know? You don't have that contract, and it's...
I know that you need to pay, and that you have so little money.
Yeah.
But I have a feeling that a lot will happen.
I gotta go.
After you took that job.
To go to...
We'll help you find a job.
Yes.
Go for her! Go for her! Go for her!
And the next part we will see in the second act, because this was the first act.
Drink, you can mingle, you can have a chat, and then we'll see the rest of this story in 50 minutes. Thank you very much. A little bit who the characters were.
Do you remember any characters from
Ryan?
Ryan.
Ryan.
Who was Ryan?
Christina.
So who was Ryan?
Who was Ryan?
Single.
Single, yes.
That was my identity.
Yeah, that's how
single.
I heard Christina.
Christina?
Yes.
Mr. and Mrs. Anderson.
Yay! Yes. This is a favorite or whatever.
And they're not married, despite their similar names.
Yeah. Which ones do we also have?
Vicky.
Victoria.
Vicky.
Sophie.
Yeah, oh, that's Vicky. And
the sister.
Susanna, we have also.
And they were married.
Mm-hmm. Susanna.
Yes.
Brian.
Sophie or something.
No.
Suzanne.
Yes.
Oh, that was Christina's friend. That was Sophie in the beginning.
I'm playing also Christina's. I think we're friends, best friends.
Roommates.
My name is Sophienne. So they're very different.
It's not confusing.
No. So good, we did the recap then.
Yeah.
So, in the first act, we saw Brian running, and so where do you think he ran to? Suggestions?
For a place.
To Christina.
And I would like a location, like a place to be, not a person.
A park.
Kensington
Park.
Hot
dog stand.
A viewpoint.
One more.
A viewpoint.
A viewpoint of Kensington Park.
Yeah.
So the second act, it will start with Brian running again. Yeah, because we like that. to a viewpoint of Kensington Park.
And that's it.
No, that's the beginning of the second act of Kiss Me Tomorrow. Woo!
I knew you were going on a date later today, so I thought you might be early in Kensington Park.
I'm supposed to meet a dreamy guy. 79.
Yeah.
You're supposed to meet down there by the hot dog stand. I'm just taking pictures.
So how long do you have? 5 minutes?
No, it's like a 15 or something. Okay.
Take a picture of you.
Okay.
Look in the camera. Wait, don't take too many pictures. You only have like, how many do you have? 24?
Yeah, I have like 3 left.
Yeah, okay.
But I have another film with me.
Ooh, wow. Okay. you always prepare so well for things.
You know, Brian, I think it's so much fun that we've, you know, worked together and, like, gone on dates because, you know, the reason, you know, they asked you in the beginning, like, have you been on any dates this year? And my answer was no, and the reason was that I didn't dare to go on any.
Really?
Yeah, I know I can seem a bit strict, but, you know, I was about to go a few times, but then I actually turned in the door. I did the same with this job.
And you didn't show up. You just.
Yeah.
Didn't turn up.
Yeah. But this is so much fun. Like it feels like we're not on. Like we are on real dates.
Well, it's real dates, but it's the same for me. It feels very natural, and it's.
Natural.
I don't need to pretend or like. Do anything that I wouldn't do. Like I can be just my awkward old self, and it's okay. And so I feel.
It's really fun. Like I also always think about the spelling errors in the menus, but you always point them out first.
Yeah, I tend to be a bit picky on. Yeah, Christina, I need to tell you something.
Yeah, cannelloni is two N's, right?
N's is two L's, and there's one N at the end. People always get it wrong. They always get it wrong.
You always get it right.
Yeah, well, okay, it took me a few tries at first. Yeah.
So what is
it? Would you like to go out with me on a date? A real, real date?
But we can't.
I know, but I feel really nice with you, and I...
You know we will lose our... Mrs. Anderson, they will...
Mr. and Mrs. Anderson! I spied!
Oh.
Need the $10
report.
First.
Can I write your check?
Yes. So...
We usually have pounds here.
You know I'm American. American contractors. Yes. So, two of your employees, I heard them talking about a date.
Oh. That's forbidden. It can't have happened.
It's not legal in the company.
No, I know.
A date.
It's against company policy to date someone at work. You can't do that.
It's against company policy.
Yes.
They can't do that.
Yes.
No, they can't.
No.
No.
It's against company policy.
It's against company policy.
Yes, it
yes.
is.
I'll look for another pair. Thank you, George! We'll do something about this! Brian? Here are the classifieds. So, I think maybe this, a flower delivery man?
Yeah, he sounds nice.
Yeah?
32, flower delivery man, likes flowers. Uh-huh. That's like, yeah, okay. Mm. Has a car.
Yeah?
Also practical.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, absolutely, but also the job ads.
That's what happened in the London Daily.
They print them on the same... Page
yeah.
And then, yeah,
so you have the romantic classified
yes.
and then the actual job classified.
Yeah.
It's confusing.
It is confusing.
Yeah,
Dreamy guys, 79.
Hi.
Hi. I'm paid for an employee of a dating incorporated.
I know.
Nice to meet you.
But they do really nice matches.
Yeah.
It's like... Heaven must have lost an angel. You.
Alright,
would you like a hot dog?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, I'm paying.
That's very sweet of you.
Yes,
is
I
it
am.
Chorizo? It seems like it's spelled wrong. I mean, if you want to go. I care.
You need a new job.
We have chorizo and we have caballos.
It says chorizo.
Don't be scared of changing jobs because it's not that easy to find a new job, and now it's working well and I'm actually enjoying this.
There's a reason I'm a hot dog vendor.
Yeah, do you have hot dogs?
I have hot dogs I cannot spell. Would you like a hot dog or not?
I like a hot dog. Do you have a hot normal hot dog?
I haven't seen you like this. You're clearly smitten with this girl.
I know,
Christina.
But you remember what happened last time with Miriam when I gave up my whole life for her. I quit the job, I changed everything. And she destroyed me. I need to stand on my 2 feet.
Are you gonna eat that one in like one end, like a romantic couple, or are you gonna have another one for yourself?
Oh, I'm such a matchmaker!
seat next to you this time.
Yes.
I'm really excited for this play.
Yeah.
I don't go with somebody else very often.
No, it's
Spring!
Excuse me.
Spring! I saved you a seat!
Sorry.
I'm
very sorry. It's okay.
Hey, lady, I saved that seat.
Oh, sorry.
So rude, right? Fred!
My God, he's always late.
Oh, Laura, is that seat taken?
Yeah.
Oh, Laura. Oh, sorry, I forgot. I forgot to buy peanuts.
I'll sit in the aisle.
I think that's my seat.
You're so late, Fred.
Oh, excuse me.
It's a contract, and if I want to get to quit, I can.
Brian, you said yourself that the contract is very restrictive. I can't help that you didn't have a lawyer review it before signing.
Who reviews a contract with a lawyer?
You know, at this company, the turnover is way too high. You need to do everything you can to keep all employees.
That's
do
right.
Everything in your power. Lie. Anything.
That's right. Is this contract technically legal, although...
No, absolutely not. But all measurements are okay now, because we can't have any more turnover with staff.
Okay, great. This is the contract that I'll give to our staff from now on.
Good.
So you're gonna sue me if I quit?
That's right, Brian. I didn't make the rules. I'm sorry.
I mean, who would make up something like that, of course? It's...
Right, Mr. Anderson and I need you and Christina. You're the best employees we've had. The dating agency isn't doing as well as we'd hoped. We think it's ahead of its time. People just aren't into dating apps yet. But we'll see that in the future, potentially. But you
Christina,
have to say.
Mm-hmm. I did something.
What did you do?
I got an idea, and you weren't home, so I took care of it myself.
You signed us up for yoga, too?
I signed you up for yoga, too. That's what I did. But you know what? Since you said that thing about making Mr. and Mrs. Anderson, like, start dating...
Yeah, I know. Such a silly idea.
I know. But you know what I did?
Uh-huh.
I set out an ad in our magazine to find a girl who wants to go on a date with Mr. Anderson and like be really, really, really bad. And that will make him want to date Mrs. Anderson. Like he will realize what he had. And there was one girl replying, and her name was Vicky something, and she was like really up for it.
Oh, so Vicky and Mr. Anderson go on a date.
Yes.
And then he will realize what he wants.
Exactly.
You got it.
I'm a genius.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sophian.
Yes, Sophian. Okay, let's go to yoga.
Brian! Brian!
Sure, yeah.
This has come to my attention. Did you have anything to do with this ad?
With this what?
Mr. Anderson, it seems, is dating.
Meanwhile, in a date.
You're too smart for me. Yeah, I usually go by this Spanish Italian place.
How is it to be on a date?
Well, stupid, you are on a date right now, so you better tell me. I'm sorry. I scare you.
No.
Well, to be on a date, you need to tell the person you're dating about, oh my god, you need to tell the person you're dating, like, who you are, and then that person gets to say if they like it or not. I'm not gonna spill that much.
I'm in love with my coworker. But we have a strict company policy against cheating.
Oh, so this would be fun then?
Yes, really fun.
Okay, I think it's better if I tell you about me instead.
Oh.
So, I'm Vicky. And I work independently with kids. I make them sell books. For my company.
Call me.
Free books for Vicky Corporation. I just ate her number.
Yes, I'll have one, yes. I think I can spare the change. £2? Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
They're really good salespeople.
Yeah, so that's what I do. I don't like apples, I don't like when people are in love with other people, and I will never, never allow you to sleep with me. That's how our relationship works, but you seem to not know that, so I better tell you. Are you having fun?
Persona, you know, and nobody there even knows me, and we have the two best employees
Brian and Christina, and Brian tried to quit, and I don't want him to quit, and he thinks I'm so terrible because I threatened to sue him, but I didn't know what else to do. And the worst thing is that Mr. Anderson, you know my colleague.
Yeah?
Well, he thinks so little of the company that there was an ad to date him in the local magazine. So he's dating now, and I thought he wasn't dating, and he's my colleague, it shouldn't bother me, but oh, it bothers me.
Hey, you can tell me. It seems like you like him. A bit more than a colleague, if you know what I mean.
Oh, so much more. I mean, when we interview together, you know, we're just on the same wavelength, and the way he questions the applicant, and the way I question the applicant, and the way I ask the question, and he checks it off the list.
So ask him out!
But there's a strict company policy.
Okay.
We're not allowed to date.
Oh. I thought you owned the company, though.
Well, the rules have to apply to everybody from the top down. What kind of an example would that be setting for our employees? I don't know. I can't bend the rules just because we're the two co-presidents of the company.
Are you sure?
Well, he told me he wasn't dating, and there's an ad in that magazine, and he's probably out with some really, really sexy, beautiful woman now, so...
No one sexier or more beautiful than you.
So, thank you.
Sophie, you think I should call her? You and I have basically also brothers and sisters. You've been with my sister for so long. I want to leave her a message.
Haven't you left her a message yet?
Seven.
Seven.
But I want to try one more. I don't know.
I mean, this is the love of your life, right? Might be the love of your life, so you should think it over.
I mean,
you know what? I think that this might be the love of your life. Look at this message that I got. Beep!
Seven messages, you said.
Yeah.
I mean.
But I don't want to seem desperate, because I am. So.
I don't think your machine is working. Try again.
Okay.
You're doing this so badly.
Okay, I'll try casual.
His voice is recorded in this seven messages with Brian's voice in this machine. I'm gonna press it again. Beep.
Hello, it's Brian. I hope you had a good day, and it's I'm sorry about what I said at the park last week, and I really would like to hang out or outside of the office because we see each other every day, obviously. But you know, maybe...
Well, that long? You left that long?
It went on for 7 more minutes! She told me I'm pretty sure she had to change the tape on the... It's, I was... When I get nervous, I just ramble on.
Brian, you have nothing to be nervous about.
I heard you had a date last night.
Yes.
I heard you think so little of our company that you placed an ad in a local magazine to have that date.
No.
No?
It wasn't me.
It wasn't you?
They looked into each other's eyes for minutes and minutes. They just sat there staring at each other.
And they talked about their lives for hours and hours. Discovered each other for good. They talked until 7 in the morning and never mentioned the dating company once.
They talked about their lives, their families, their hopes and dreams. And they realized they had so much more in common than just the company. They were interested in food and travels
and movies. He has seen all the romantic comedies you can think of.
Mr. Anderson, it has come to my attention that if we had the desire, we do have the power to change our company policy on no dating.
But it's a very strict policy.
It is a very strict policy, and it was put in place for good reason, I agree.
I think we should change the policy then.
I agree.
We are gathered here today to marry these two nice people, Mr. and Mrs. Anderson. So, Mr. Anderson, do you take this Mrs. Anderson as your wife?
I do.
Mrs. Anderson, do you take this?
Wait.
Mr. Anderson.
I thought they had first
your
names.
Husband.
I do.
Wait, you don't have any first names?
It's Mr. and Mrs.
So you have to be first name so that the marriage is legal.
Wait, what? So you're technically Mrs. Anderson and Mr. Anderson.
That's your first name as well.
So original.
So I take your last name or should you take mine?
We'll figure it out at the courthouse, honey.
Yeah.
Hey, Minister, this must be very little paperwork for you then after.
Yes.
You don't have to fix the names or anything.
I can go home early today.
You can go home early. I'm so happy for everybody.
Thank you. I now pronounce you Mr. and Mrs. Anderson.
I've been interpreting the last thing that Brian said on the message.
Mm-hmm.
He did say call me.
Yes.
Did you notice that, Christina?
Yes.
Yeah. Have you called him?
Not exactly, no.
How can you not exactly call someone? There's not like...
Well, you know, I started to dial...
Oh, you always start with something and you never...
I'm sorry. And then I hung up.
Have you called her again?
No.
Now that the company policy might change.
It has changed. It must have changed.
You know, I don't think it's about the company. It's, you know, she's... I don't think she's into me, because now that it seems to be loosening up in the company and she hasn't called or given a sign, and I didn't see any signal, and she hasn't called back, I think she's not interested in me. I need to move on.
Brian and Christina, can you please come into our office? As you know, Mr. Anderson and I participated in nuptial agreements last week.
What?
We participated in nuptial agreements last week.
Oh yeah, you got married, yeah.
And
congratulations.
We're...
Congratulations.
Thank you,
Christina.
Congratulations,
yeah.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you,
Brian.
Are you going to quit then?
No, as you may have heard rumors, the company policy on no dating has changed, and we would also like to host a small shindig at our house.
Shindig?
Yes, that's right. There will be dancing and there will be celebration and music.
So who else is invited?
Everyone who works for the company is invited. And my good friend Margaret is invited.
Okay. So the other employees as well are invited as well.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yes.
George is invited. You know George, our other employee. And our lawyer.
Yeah. Yes, all of our friends.
Should we come as participants of the Dating Incorporated? wounded or as civilians?
As civilians, Christina, that's a very good question, but we want you to let loose and enjoy yourselves as we have done together.
It was the evening of the shindig! Mr. and Mrs. Anderson had prepped all day. They had Greek roots, both of them. So they made some Greek food, Greek salad, souvlaki.
Okay, wait, I thought it was his costume party. I came with a like traditional Greek costume.
Yeah, I have a costume.
It's not the same, and I have my fencing sword. And
I also dressed up in a Greek costume.
The costume is not wonderful, gentlemen.
Oh, you're not dressed up. I came as a goat. I've never been to Greece, but I like goat and chase.
And I dress like Baba and Mamma Mia.
Good.
You know, when some people, when they write feta with two T's, it drives me crazy.
So, hey, everyone, I'm a feta cheese.
What is for you?
Margarine.
So it's kind of quiet so far.
So far, but we'll turn on the music shortly. There will be dancing.
Yes, it will be a wild shindig.
That's right. We've invited another friend. Victoria, who Mr. Anderson made acquaintance with a few weeks ago. The music is starting.
Shepherd in traditional costume with a fencing sword.
Do you know how to use the fencing sword?
Kind of, actually. Yeah, a little. Yeah.
Cool.
I've been doing it for a couple of years. It's fun. You need to focus. You cannot like think of, you know, what you don't do right in life or whatever. You can just focus on your partner. It's actually nice.
Brian and Christina realized that the song that was playing was actually the final song of a theater show they were watching last week called Kiss Me Tomorrow.
No, I love that song.
Yes! The bird when he... the ending, but it's so sad.
Yeah, the bird comes down from the tree,
mm-hmm.
and then the two lovers, like, the bird actually makes on the guy, but then they still kiss. I love your laugh. I love your laugh. Yes,
you really did love her laugh. And they locked eyes. And it was like the whole world stood still for a moment.
I'm easy with the hoofs. I'm sorry I called you so many times. I'm sorry. It's just I feel so... You make me laugh.
I'm sorry I didn't return your calls. I was about to. But I... Oh, I don't know. I'm not bad with doing things that I'm supposed to do.
It's okay, yeah, I understand. Like, you told me that. Like,
yeah.
It was stupid of me to put pressure on you, and that you would feel pressure to call back, and it makes it worse.
Mm.
So I can walk away. I can walk away. I don't want to force
you. No, don't walk away. No, I want you to stay here, and I want you to... I think we should be together, and it's just that I'm a very slow person, and I don't really dare to do stuff, so perhaps just kiss me tomorrow.
Terrific audience, it's been amazing.
Yeah, it's been an amazing show tonight, and we are so happy.
We're so happy.
So much love.
So much love.
Woo! Yeah.
So that's the end of our show, but we have one more show tomorrow at 2 p.m. This is the last show.
Yeah, and also, like, if you can't go tomorrow, then you can look forward to, we will have some shows in June.
June 14th to 16th.
Yeah.
Mark them in your calendar.
Yeah, mark that, yeah. The week before midsummer. So, yeah. Everyone is free then.
Yeah. So. And if you want to see more improv from it, we have one more show from the other show, from the other production class. And they're doing an improv / script format called Medley of Madness. So you don't want to miss out. It's tomorrow night at 7.
Woo!
Woo!
Maybe not a selfie because it's the 90s, but oh, let's see what we can
do. Is that okay?
Yes.
Do we actually have a phone?
Yes.
You've been such an amazing audience. We want to make this forever.
Save this moment.
Yep.
We'll
take
one.
To here or where?
Well,
we did this on Thursday too. It was very fun.